why I was so shallow and instantly, like when I saw him, I was like, nope, that can't be true. I don't know.
Do you regret giving Ben a kissing lesson on The Bachelor?
Oh my goodness, I can't believe we're going there. That was literally a decade ago. I probably pink because I still blush over this. I mean, how could you not, right? I honestly have zero regrets though, because he came in kissing me like that. And I was like, I was just so painfully awkward and weird. And that's just who I am. I am still painfully awkward and weird. And what's really interesting is back then I would be so embarrassed of myself and like put myself down for like being awkward and weird. But it's like, come into your own. It's fine. Like, we weren't meant to be. We never would be. I don't like the way it kissed, obviously. And so, I mean, I have no regrets. No regrets at all. I mean, it led me to my husband, so I'm okay.
100%. Do you ever regret saying that you weren't attracted to Doug when you first met him?
I really believe in... I have no regrets for saying that, because I really believe in being honest. I wouldn't have wanted to lie to him because we're filming a TV show and like all of America's watching. Like, that wouldn't be fair. Like, I was on The Bachelor, and that seemed very staged a bit to me. And I thought going into Married at First Sight, it was different. And then on my wedding day, the reason I panicked was that I really put so much like faith and trust in the experts. And I was like, I really believe they were getting someone who I like would spend forever with. And why I was so shallow and instantly, like when I saw him, I was like, nope, that can't be true. I don't know, but you live and you learn. And what I have learned is that brutal honesty is unnecessary. Honesty is always necessary, but brutal honesty, not so much. Yeah. And so no regrets, but live and learn, and definitely change too. Like, you know, like don't, I mean, I wouldn't, if I could do it again, I wouldn't have had that reaction, that's for sure.
Right. And then do you regret anything about your first year of marriage?
I don't think so. I think that, you know, off the top of my head, not really. The only thing I guess I would say is that, and that one thing I would ask my daughter and my son to maybe do is go to therapy your whole entire first year of marriage. Like, you think, well, first of all, if you marry someone that you think you know, when you become married, like, it does change things. It's illegal. I mean, this is a legally binding, like, you know, union. And so, you know, if you're really serious about it, like, go to therapy. Even if you think you're the strongest and the best and you'll never have a problem, just go to therapy, like, prophylactically, so that when you do have a problem, it can help, like, guide you through. And if I have any regrets, I wish that we had, and I really don't, but therapy, you know, is just so incredibly helpful to so many people. And I think that could have helped us with so many problems with like miscommunication and just all the things that happen when, you know, like a therapist just happened. I don't know, like, do you go to therapy? Like, therapy is just so helpful.
Yeah, we don't now, but we have in the past, and it's definitely helpful. And it's good to get somebody else's perspective that doesn't really know you. So it does help.
Because I feel like if you're fighting and is a married couple, if you're arguing, well, he'll tend to go to his family to vent. I'll tend to go to mine. But then all they hear is us venting. And so then it becomes way bigger of an issue than if you have like this third party who has like no personal feelings attached. Mm-hmm. And then they can tell you, you're actually being irrational and, you know, back it up, or actually, he has a point and you should probably listen. And, you know, and so that would probably be my only advice to anybody who's like going to get married, or my own children, or myself back then, is just stick with therapy. There's nothing, you know, that's an amazing way to communicate and kind of learn to grow together.